Hello, welcome to Guidancy Education Channel. In this channel, I am uploading videos pertaining to class 11, that is plus 1 chemistry and physics, and also class 12, that is plus 2 physics and chemistry. Videos are included in chapter wise playlist. You can visit the channel and select the desired playlist and watch the entire chapter together. Please watch each video completely so that you get all points clear. And if you think the video is useful, do like the video, share the video, and also leave your feedbacks as comments in the comment box below. If you have not yet subscribed my channel, do subscribe it now, which is a great motivation for me. And also press the bell button so that you get intimated as soon as new videos are posted. In this video, we are continuing class 11 chemistry chapter 2. Structure of atom. Under that we are doing quantum mechanical model, and let us see the topic that is discussed in this video. The topic discussed is filling of electrons, and under that Hund's rule. This is part 11 of quantum mechanical model. Come, let us see the topic. Hund's rule of maximum multiplicity. What does this principle state? It states that pairing of electrons in p, d and f orbitals cannot take place until each degenerate orbital of the subshell is occupied by one electron each or is singly occupied. As per Pauli's exclusion principle, an orbital can have only a maximum of two electrons with opposite spin. But Hund's rule says that an orbital can have the second electron only after all the degenerate orbitals have one electron each. P subshell has three degenerate orbitals, that is having same energy. D has five orbitals and F has seven orbitals. So when electrons are distributed, the degenerate orbitals should be first filled by one single electron first. They should be singly occupied. Then only pairing can start. Okay, now let us see what is maximum multiplicity. Maximum multiplicity means total spin of unpaired electrons in the atom. That is, when the degenerate orbitals get filled by one electron each before getting paired fully, there will be unpaired electrons in the orbital. The spin of those electrons alone is considered. And that possibility where the spin total is maximum is the electronic configuration of that atom. I will explain that with the help of an example, that is nitrogen. The atomic number is 7. The subshell electron configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. In this configuration, you cannot know how these three electrons in the p subshell are distributed at the orbital level. Let us see that orbital electron configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2px1, 2py1 and 2pz1. So the total becomes 7. That this is for nitrogen. Let us see all the possible ways in which the electron can be distributed. This is one possibility. We will see the orbital picture diagram. This is 1s2, this is 2s2, and this is the 2p orbitals, 3 in number. And each one, that is x, y and z, are occupied by one electron each. They are all in the same direction. So this is option A. Let us see option B. Here the p orbital has, there are 3 electrons in 3 separate p orbitals, but one electron here is in the opposite direction. What is the next possibility? Here only one electron of the p orbital is unpaired. Px has paired electron and the last orbital is vacant. Let us see which one of these has the maximum total spin, that is maximum multiplicity. What is the spin value? The spin can be either clockwise or anti-clockwise. So The spin value is given as positive half and negative half. Okay, so for A, the total spin will be half plus half plus half, that is equal to 1.5. All the three electrons are aligned in the same direction. So if this is taken as clockwise, so all the three are taken as positive. In option B, one electron is in the opposite direction. So the magnitude of the spin becomes half plus negative half plus positive half. That becomes half only. What will be the value for C option? There is only one electron which is unpaired. So here the value will be half only. So maximum multiplicity is for option A. So the electron should be distributed as is shown under A. The electrons occupying the three orbitals of P should be in the same direction. That is, all the three should be either in the upward direction or in the downward direction. Here we have shown them in the upward direction. Okay, I hope it is clear. If you think the video is useful, do like the video, share the video, and also leave your feedbacks as comments in the comment box below. Your subscriptions are great motivation for me. Keep supporting me and also press the bell button so that you get intimated as soon as new videos are posted. We will meet in the next video with the application of these three rules, that is, Aufbau principle, Pauli's exclusion principle, and also Hund's rule, and then how electrons are filled in the orbitals. Bye for the present. Take care.